Get ready, America, for this is the best of Destination Small Town, a Cluck TV production, featuring the shows that have taken Sweet Swine County by storm. The reality hit, The Real Housewives of Sweet Swine County, Sweet Swine's favorite music show, Backstage at the Commune, the tastefully done cooking segment, Cooking It Up with Betty, the always zany soap opera, As the Corn Grows, and of course, the wildly popular talk shows that share what's happening inside and outside Sweet Swine County. Which shows will you be seeing today? Stay tuned and find out right after the break.
This program is made possible in part by Swine Tales Publications, the proud publisher of Sweet Swine County maps and plat books, now publishing authors from throughout Sweet Swine County. Swine Tales Publication is now making plans for their next book tour, and they may be held in these small towns with the release of The Sweet Swine Diaries, a collection of unauthorized biographies by Cassidy Davis, featuring a riveting collection of the exotic, neurotic, chaotic, and even psychotic stories about the lives of the Sweet Swine County ladies. Miss Davis is quoted as saying, "I have never seen so many single women with so many problems in my life. Enjoy." Each of these towns and their businesses are being considered to hold a book signing because of the information found on the best source about small towns of the Midwest. To learn about these towns and their businesses, visit DestinationSmallTown.com.
What's Cooking? A KLUK TV production. Starring Abby Appetite, Lenny, and Lola Leftover. Their destination, outside Sweet Swine County. Their purpose, to share their discoveries of the best cafes, restaurants, bakeries, supper clubs, and night spots. It all began when they realized food options in Sweet Swine County were limited. Now you can learn what they learned, with hundreds of food options. What's Cooking? In living color on the web.
This program is made possible in part by Swine Tales Publications, the proud publisher of Sweet Swine County maps and plat books, now publishing authors from throughout Sweet Swine County. Swine Tales Publication is now making plans for their next book tour, and they may be held in these small towns with the release of Poems I Wrote and More Poems I Wrote, by Sweet Swine County's own Poet Laureate, Ronnie P. Silage. After serving as Poet Laureate of Sweet Swine County for over 20 years, Ronnie was encouraged to put his poetic masterpiece in book form for all to cherish and enjoy. With a wealth of life experiences to draw upon, Ronnie P. is a veritable pit of poetic musings and life lessons learned. Each of these towns and their businesses are being considered to hold a book signing because of the information found on the best source about small towns of the Midwest. To learn about these towns and their businesses, visit DestinationSmallTown.com.
Join us now for another exciting episode of As the Corn Grows. As we remember last time, Katie received a Christmas Eve surprise when Cousin John delivered a fruitcake with his main squeeze, Aunt Minnie. Today we join Mrs. Swanson as she caters the big New Year's Eve gala. Prairie Ann, as she nervously awaits her turn in the gala talent show. And Elmer, as he safely lights all the candles at the Night to Remember ball.
Get that finger. My goodness.
I'm just a little embarrassed, I guess.
Embarrassed?
Well, I'm supposed to be this big farm safety expert, and I go burn my finger off.
Isn't this grand? It's like a big
Hollywood party. Well, kind of like a Hollywood party. We have celebrities and entertainment. Oh, giddy up.
Slow down, Prairie Ann. You're going to burn out before the evening is over. I'd ask you to join us, but...
Oh, I'd love to.
Prairie Ann, you just get over here and help me with this buffet.
Oh, I can't. I've got a prior commitment.
Well, I hope you three wore your dancing shoes tonight. This is going to be one evening to remember.
Well, Cousin John, everything looks so lovely, and it was very gracious of you to invite us, considering.
Considering what? We are family, after all, and hey, it's the holidays. You know, we didn't have time the other night for proper introductions with all those fruitcakes and things.
Yes. Well, Cousin John and Aunt Minnie, this is Cassidy Davis.
Cassidy Davis, the famous singing star? Can I have your autograph?
I don't know about famous. I did have that number one hit for Gemini Studios.
Cousin John, I can't wait for the talent show. I have been practicing my juggling all week.
Talent show? What talent show?
No big deal, really. Each year we draw poker chips, and those people that get the black chips, they're our entertainment for the evening.
Sounds like fun!
Well, for you, maybe, because you can sing, but what about the rest of us?
Oh, well, this is how it works. If you draw the black chip, you have to do something. And if you don't, tomorrow morning, everybody is going to make fun of you. And they'll never, ever invite you to anything ever again.
About time you got here.
Hold on, little girl. You ain't the boss of me.
Well, the soybean fungus worked, and the deer ate half the corn harvest, but...
But nothing. She's finished. There is no way that she's going to make that loan payment come this spring.
I don't know, Cousin John. She's clever. She took in a boarder, and her magazine salary's going to start in April again.
Listen. I figured she might come up with something like this. Why do you think I invited her here tonight?
No, Cousin John. Well, what are you up to?
Well, when everybody in town, including little Miss Katie, is here at my shindig, I've got somebody paying a little visit out to the farm to take care of a few things.
Ah. Cousin John, you crazy old cute. Well, if you weren't knocking boots with Minnie and I wasn't in love with Elmer.
Oh, that's enough. You just make sure that she draws a black chip for the entertainment tonight. That way she's here till midnight, gives my man enough time to take care of what he needs to take care of.
No problem. I'll hand out the entertainment chips.
And don't worry about that boarder. How much rent's she getting from him anyway?
$300.
$300 isn't chicken feed. Don't get your knickers in a knot. Let me tell you what we're gonna do.
Well, what are you two plotting?
Oh, nothing, Mrs. Swanson. I'm just handing out entertainment chips.
Well, listen, you get out here and help me. I'm running out of drummies. And the dips a quart low.
Katie, can I talk to you a moment privately?
Why, sure, Norma. And don't you look lovely tonight?
Thank you. Aren't you just the sweetest thing? Katie, I know it's probably none of my business.
What's wrong, Norma?
Well, I just thought you should know that Prairie Ann and Cousin John had a little rendezvous at Edie's last week.
Cousin John and Prairie Ann?
That's right. They got real quiet when I got near the table. But they did mention your name a couple times.
Prairie Ann and Cousin John were discussing me?
I'd watch my back, Katie. I don't know what Prairie Ann is up to, but Cousin John is real ruthless when it comes to getting his way.
Well, Norma, I want to thank you so much for this inside information. You're a good friend.
This program is made possible in part by Swine Tales Publications, the proud publisher of Sweet Swine County Maps and Plat Books, now publishing authors from throughout Sweet Swine County. Swine Tales Publication is now making plans for their next book tour, and they may be held in these small towns with the release of Plowing Through Life by renowned life coach Elmer Plow. Elmer shares his proven five-step plan for a better life. With advice that includes get a grip and snap out of it, Elmer's program is so ingenious in its simplicity and detail. It's sure to help a couple of people. Each of these towns and their businesses are being considered to hold a book signing because of the information found on the best source about small towns of the Midwest. To learn about these towns and their businesses, visit DestinationSmallTown.com. This program has been made possible by The Daily Boar. This sometimes daily newspaper reports the news the residents of Sweet Swine County want to know. Also now featured online at SweetSwineScoop.com.
Get ready, because now you can watch a full of fun daytime talk show that shares the latest and greatest news about the people, places, and events found all over our story country. The Women of Sweet Swine County, hosted by three sassy ladies that tell small town stories with big town attitude. Now, on this station and the web. To As the Corn Grows!
Okay, you two, you're the last ones to drop.
Please be white, please be white, please be white, please be white.
You can open your eyes now. It's black! Feels like there's only one left.
Well, you two are the last ones to drop.
It's black. It's black. Okay, when do I go on? Where do I stand? Are there going to be cameras rolling? How's my hair?
Slow down, pop star. I'm really glad that you're in seventh heaven, but what about the rest of us?
It's okay, Katie. You'll think of something. You have to. It's a tradition. Mrs. McCoy refused to sing one year, and she was shunned for a whole year by the Faith Bible Circle. She never did that again.
Marianne, she's ruining my life!
Is everybody having a good time tonight? Well, before we get this shindig started, as you all know, I need to introduce the MC for tonight. And we pass the chips around, and the guy or the gal that draws the red chip is our MC for tonight. Tonight's MC is Ronnie Silage. The stage is yours.
Well, the only reason I'm doing this is because of Mrs. Swanson's upside down cake.
But you ate it all. You ate all the crumbs and you even licked the plate.
All right.
Hey, let's get this show on the road. We want a show.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 40th annual New Year's Night to Remember, and what a night we got!
Come on, it's almost morning, it's coming fast, let's get this on.
Settle down.
Let's go!
And now, I want to introduce, all the way from Mankato, Minnesota, Aunt Ella's favorite cowboy singer, and a frequent visitor to her farm, Lonesome Ronnie!
Good evening, ladies and gents. I'd like to sing one of Aunt Ella's favorite songs. It was many a night that we sat on the front porch, I gazed in those big brown eyes, singing songs of love and...
You gonna keep walking us down memory lane, or are you gonna sing a song or what?
And I got a wonderful song for her and you. There's a place just beyond the tracks that every cowboy knows, where he can kick off his boots and relax.
So, Minnie, how do you like the party?
Oh, my Cousin John.
Don't call me Cousin John, just John. It's creepy enough dating my step aunt, but just call me John.
Well, if I'm so creepy, then we better end this date right now, cuz.
Relax.
I mean, John.
It's not that you're creepy. It's just, you know, dating my step aunt and all that. Here, have some more wine.
You will know that you have found the house of Dakota Rose. Yes, the house of Dakota Rose.
Thank you. Well, tonight we have a special treat for you.
Only if you get off the stage, Ronnie. Silence.
You just wait. You just wait. Now, just a minute here, ladies and gentlemen. Now, from the bright lights of Hollywood, Miss Cassidy Davis.
Thank you. As many of you know, I am switching from pop to country, so here's an old song about love gone tragically wrong. Yes. Frankie and Johnny were lovers. Lordy, how they did love.
I don't really have to do this, do I, Elmer?
Prairie Ann was not kidding about the consequences of not taking your turn under the lights, Katie. I'd love to help you, but I drew a white chip, and I've been practicing my juggling all week. I only knocked out the cat once this week.
Elmer, that's all well and good, but what about me?
Well, can you dance? Can you play the piano? Can you saw a sword? Oh, God, that's dangerous. What am I thinking?
Elmer, that's it. I know what I'm going to do.
I ain't gonna tell you no story.
Johnny, when are you gonna get my farm back for me?
Why not get my farm back? Well.
Hey, these things take time. Besides, if you had done what I told you to do and got lawyer Ed to switch Aunt Ella's will to get you included, we wouldn't be where we're at right now.
Oh, Johnny, let's not fight. I tried my best with lawyer Ed, but all he's interested in is his stupid pet duck Quackers.
Well, 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 get a room, you two.
Back to your dip, old lady.
And Johnny's been making love to him really blind. He was your man, but he is doing you wrong.
Voice lessons with Lonesome Ron has really paid off. Well, now everybody, before we go on to our next act, I want to read my latest poem to my lady love.
Oh, poetry. Pinch me, I think I must be dreaming.
Your giddy up got me from the get-go. Branding our spirits for the ages. Perhaps we should be put in cages. As we together, like the corn, grow and grow and grow.
Or throw Ronnie Silage out into the snow.
Ladies and gentlemen, I bring you again from the far, far east, the beautiful, the lovely, the talented, the exotic, Princess Fatima! Woo!
Well, Cousin John, are you done smooching with Minnie?
Listen, old lady, not a word of this to anyone. Do you understand me? Or next year somebody else will be catering this shindig. You'll be standing on the corner begging for change.
Why, that sounds like a threat, Cousin John.
You've been warned, old lady.
Well,
say, where's that assistant of yours?
Well, I don't know. She's not in the supply room with you.
Oh, I'm sure she's around here somewhere.
She better get back here soon. I've got just 2 Swedish meatballs left and just a little bit of party mix.
Oh, cool your heels. Nobody's eating during the show anyway.
Oh,
Chandler, that's not safe. You can't do that. That's dangerous.
Sure?
Yes, it's very dangerous. You can't do that.
Oh, Mrs. Swanson, Elmer was just helping me get ready for the talent show.
Well, looks like you two are getting ready for something. Just a minute. Just a minute. I want to talk to you a minute. This storeroom has seen more action than the Starlight Motel.
Oh, Mrs. Swanson, we weren't.
Well, I'm going to tell you this. First, I caught Cousin John and Prairie Ann. Then I caught Cousin John with Aunt Minnie. Then I caught you and Katie in here. I think there's something in the water.
Hold on here. You said Cousin John and Prairie Ann?
Yes. They had their heads together plotting something.
You know, come to think of it, I've seen those two around town a whole lot lately. You don't think they're...
Oh, no. She wouldn't have anything to do with that old coot.
Well, I don't know, Mrs. Swanson.
Someone we all know who's real experienced in the world of entertainment.
Whoa, folks, that's a relief.
Shame on you, Reverend Bill. Shame on you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, someone we all know, as I was trying to say, our own Lawyer Ed and his sidekick, Quackers!
Thank you all for inviting me here today. It gives me another opportunity to promote the art of ventriloquism. That's one of my quests and my goals in life, is to promote ventriloquism to the art form that it truly deserves. And this is my friend Quackers here. Quackers, what do you think of the party so far? It's not really all it's quacked up to be, is it? No. Actually, no, it isn't, Quackers. It's kind of really on the slow side so far.
Elmer!
Jeez, Prairie Ann, don't you know any better not to sneak up on a guy?
I'm sorry. Did you like Princess Fatima's act?
Sure did, but let me tell you something. She is a walking safety hazard. That veil was so thick, I don't see how she could see anything. She could have fallen off the stage. And that necklace flying around like a helicopter. And the metal doohickeys. I'm surprised I'm still here.
Didn't you like anything about her?
Sure did. I like the fact that she didn't almost knock me off the stage.
Well, that's right, because crackers make quackers crazy, don't they? Quackers say goodnight. Good night, quackers.
Oh, look, quackers, the dummy's back.
All right, settle down. Now, ladies and hecklers, tonight I bring you from the world of interior design, Mr. Dougie Dugan!
Please. Well, if you're gonna be like that...
I don't know, I hope this works.
Oh, don't worry, you're gonna be great.
Cassidy, would you please excuse us? I have to have a word with Prairie Ann.
Oh, okay. I'll just go keep Elmer company on our table for a little while.
Okay. What's up? Funny thing. That's just what I was about to ask you, little Miss Prairie Ann.
Oh, whatever do you mean?
Oh, don't play dumb with me, Prairie Ann. You flit around all sweetness and light. I thought we were friends.
How many glasses of champagne have you had, Katie?
Not nearly enough. You she-wolf in sheep's clothing. I know you've been keeping company with Cousin John.
Cousin John? Are you insane?
No, but I'm starting to think that you are.
Hey, Ronnie Silage out there. He's about ready to blow a gasket, Katie. Looking for you? Something about your big debut.
Thank you. And you and I, we're not done yet, little Miss Sunshine.
And as the policeman looked down at the clown's shoe, he said, "You're going to need a bigger car if you're going to wear shoes that size." So good night, everybody. Good night.
Thank you, Doggy Dogan. And now I think we have time for one more act before midnight. And now it's going to be our next contestant, Urban Katie, who I'm told has the face of an angel and the voice to match.
Well then, if she had a set of wings, she could fly.
Now, cut that out! It's almost midnight! We gotta get on with this act!
I can't wait. I'm on cloud nine.
I'm warning you, Chef Randy! I'm warning you!
I'm warning you, Chef Randy.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome our own Urban Katie!
Oh no, it's midnight. Where's Amber?
Lonesome Ron, get over here.
Well, now isn't that a showstopper? Will Mrs. Swanson get her New Year's kiss from Lonesome Ron? Will Prairie Anne have to settle for an admiring look from Ronnie Silage? Will Katie be forced to make her stage debut? And will Elmer Plow's fingers recover from the unfortunate match lighting incident? From our family to yours, may you have the happiest of New Year's and join us next time on As the Corn Grows! Get ready, because just when you thought you'd gotten the Cockleburrs out of your overalls, they're now on TV. That's right, this is one weed you won't want to pull. The Cockleburr Morning Show, with hosts who deliver a mix of news, entertainment, and information about the communities throughout our story country. Now on this station and the web. Get ready, because our culinary expert and, dare we say, wine aficionado beyond belief, Betty Thompson, is preparing some tantalizing dishes for us on her show, Cooking It Up with Betty. In the midst of cooking, our dear old Betty does join her What's Cooking reporters traveling throughout our story country. Now, on this station and the web.
This program is made possible in part by Swine Tales Publications, the proud publisher of Sweet Swine County Maps and Plat Books, now publishing authors from throughout Sweet Swine County. Swine Tales Publication is now making plans for their next book tour, and they may be held in these small towns with the release of One Duck, One Ventriloquist, An Autobiography by Lawyer Ed. Talented, driven, hungry for fortune and fame, the story of a man and his wooden duck against the world. The High Horse Herald says, "This guy quacks me up. What a character, and the lawyer's funny too." The New Pork Periodical says, "Best $2 I ever spent on a book." Each of these towns and their businesses are being considered to hold a book signing because of the information found on the best source about small towns of the Midwest. To learn about these towns and their businesses, visit DestinationSmallTown.com. This program has been made possible by Purdue University, Sweet Swine County's Institute of Higher Learning, with 3 classroom trailers that can accommodate up to 9 students each. To learn more, visit SweetSwineScoop.com.
Get ready, because now you can see a late-night talk show filmed in front of a discerning yet agreeable studio audience. Split Hoof tonight! Cousin John and his incomparable sidekick, Earl Silo, interview a roster of guests who make appearances that you won't want to miss. Now on this station and the web.